was. I used to make toys like all the other little dummies, but that was when I was much younger. Now Santa has a special job for me. Did you ever hear the door close? And you look around, and there isn't anybody there, and the shutter goes bang, 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 and there isn't any wind, and the floor creaks, and you sit up in bed and you say, "Is that you, Daddy?" Well, it isn't your daddy, nor your mommy, neither. It's me. I'm the little brownie that goes around to all the children's houses to see if they've been good little boys and girls. Yes, sir. I know all about you little boys and girls. I know the ones that ate their breakfast and those who put away their toys. Which brings me to the reason why Santa sent me here to talk to you. From what I see, and from what we hear way up in Toyland, a lot of the toys that Santa and his brownies have worked so hard to make get broken and lost and left out in the rain. You see, I have another job, too. All of the toys that are broken and forgotten, Santa has me pick up in a big basket and take to the land of lost and forgotten toys. Well, none of the toys want to go there, as you can surely imagine. So, Santa thought that if I came here and told you how the Fairy Snow Queen first gave toys life, but then you would appreciate them more and take better care of them. Toys first learned to talk a long time ago in Toyland. It happened on Christmas Eve. Once upon a time, Santa and his brownies had just finished making all the toys for Christmas, and Santa was getting ready to take them to all the good little boys and girls. Well, sir, every Christmas Eve, Santa has a cup of tea with an old friend, because a cup of tea gives Santa just the right send-off for his long, fast journey. Now, on this certain Christmas Eve that I am telling you about, Santa had asked the Fairy Snow Queen.
Oh, dear Fairy Snow Queen,
said Santa,
won't you come have a sugar cookie and a cup of hot tea with me?
A cup of hot tea?
Cried the Fairy Snow Queen in horror.
Mercy, no. I would not await.
Oh, I see.
But I will come and have a sugar cookie with you. It's much nicer than tea.
And that's exactly what she did. But Santa had been working so hard with his brownies to get all the toys ready for Christmas that he forgot all about the sugar cookie. And before the Fairy Snow Queen came, Santa fell asleep with all his toys at his feet. Now, old Santa had only been asleep for 1 minute when the door opened, and there was the Fairy Snow Queen, dancing in the snow. She was the most beautiful fairy of all. But I'll tell you a little secret. She loves to play jokes.
That old sugar cookie isn't even up there. That's a fine thing for him to do. Besides, it might have been fun. Oh, well. Oh, dear. Oh, hum. I ought not to be treated like this. I should teach Santa a lesson. Something like a good joke.
Oh, wonderful.
Besides, it will give me something to do. And there's certainly no harm in a tiny little joke. Let's see what I could do. Oh, what a funny looking little doll. I wonder how it would be if... Of course! I grant all these toys life. Oh, this will be a wonderful joke.
Fills me with joy and happiness. Let's all try and sing together while starlight fills the sky.
Better change the toys back so I can put them in my sack.
Oh, not yet, Santa. Let me show you how I can march.
Oh, yes, 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 yes.
Watch me!
Quickly, Fairy Snow Queen. Change him back, or he will break himself sure.
Oh, don't worry, Santa.
Look out! Look out!
Look out!
Jack, you stay in your box.
Can't stop! Can't stop! Can't stop!
Thank you.
change them back, Fairy Snow Queen, before something terrible happens to them. They may get hurt or fall in love.
All right, Santa. Oh, but they're having such fun. Well, you must promise me first that you won't fall asleep the next time you ask me to come and have a sugar cookie with you.
Yes, I promise you I will not fall asleep again. But please, change the toys back to toys before they break themselves.
All right, Santa. Now, toys, be as Santa made you. Toys! I said be as you were.
No.
What's the matter, Fairy Snow Queen? Why do not the toys change? Look, they're still the same. Is this another one of your jokes?
A joke, a joke, a joke.
No, I'm not joking now, Santa. I don't know what the matter is. Everything seems connected.
But you must change them back. Oh, what is it? Why are you crying?
I've lost my magic power.
You can't change them back?
No.
But why, Fairy Snow Queen? Why?
Well, Santa, the Queen of the Fairies told me that if I didn't stop playing jokes, she would take away all of my magic power for 400 Christmases. I've played a joke on you, Santa, and now I've lost my magic. Oh, dear.
Oh, that's too bad, Fairy Snow Queen. But what shall I do? I have no toys to give the children for Christmas.
I know. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
We don't want to be just toys.
We don't want to. We don't want to. We don't want to.
We don't want to be just toys.
Just toys. Just toys. Just toys.
That's it. That's why my magic wouldn't work. You see, Santa, as a Fairy Snow Queen, my powers are limited. I can only change things that want to be changed. The toys wanted to be made alive, but they do not want to be turned back to toys again.
Oh, you should have thought of that before you changed them.
I know I should have, Santa. I'm very sorry, and I will never play jokes on anyone again.
But what shall I do? It's time that I started.
Well, maybe,
Santa, your sled and reindeer are ready.
Well, maybe if I talk to them. Now, toys, you've all had a chance to see how it is to be alive. You've had your fun. Please let me change you back. Oh, please.
I want to sing all the time.
I want to march all the time.
We want to stay alive.
I want to eat candy and cookies.
Sugar cookie, sugar cookie, sugar cookie.
But I promised the little children I would bring them toys. That's what you were made for, to bring happiness to little boys and girls. You weren't made for living. Would you have all the little children in the world crying on Christmas? Would you?
No.
Then let the Fairy Snow Queen change you back. It's not easy being alive. Why, you're so tiny. How will you get along with no little boy or girl to look after you? What will become of you? A toy soldier, you can only march now. But if you belong to some little boy, he would put you with a lot of other soldiers.
He would? Really?
Why, he might even send you to war.
A real war? Honest?
Sure, a little boy's war. And you dolls. Why, you could go to tea parties and be well taken care of. But alone in the big world, you will all soon get lost and broken. Your arms and legs will fall off. And it will be very sad. I'll tell my brownies to unhitch the Christmas sled. There will not be any toys. Tomorrow, Christmas morning, which is usually the happiest day of the year, will now be known as the saddest. No toys. My, my.
Oh, Santa, may I make a suggestion?
Oh, of course.
Well, how would it be to let all the toys come to life for 1 hour every night at 12 o'clock? Then, appoint one of your brownies to go around and ask the toys if the little girl or boy they belong to has been nice to them. It would be a wonderful way to check up on the little boys or girls. And besides, It might be fun.
Oh, boy, that's a fine idea, Fairy Snow Queen. Would you agree to that, toys?
A conference, a conference, a conference. Agreed, agreed, agreed.
Oh, and you, my little brownie, will hereafter be called Snoopy. That will be your job, to check up on the dolls and record their complaints.
Yes, sir, Santa, yes, sir.
And now, Fairy Snow Queen.
Now, toys, please go back to the position you were in when I first granted you life.
What's that?
Listen, someone's crying.
It's the musical doll.
Oh, look, Santa, look. I've never seen a doll cry before.
Musical doll? Why are you crying?
I love. Oh, dear.
Mm-hmm. I was afraid of this. With whom are you in love, musical doll?
With the toy soldier.
Imagine in love.
How does it feel?
Does it hurt?
Is it nice?
Go away, all of you. I'm in love with a musical doll, too.
Fairy Snow Queen, what shall we do?
Well, the toys cannot be changed unless the musical doll and the toy soldier agree to be happy.
Oh, dear.
We agree to be changed, Santa. We wouldn't want to make all the little children unhappy. But before we do, what...
Black kiss.
Oh. You see, toys... It's not easy being alive.
Yes, we see, Santa.
Are you both ready now?
One last thing, Santa.
Oh, hurry, toy soldier.
Let me give you my gold medal as a token of our love.
And hereafter, all musical dolls will wear gold pins in remembrance of the two toys who fell in love.
How nice. How sweet.
What fun.
And now, Fairy Snow Queen, I believe we're ready.
Now, may all the toys be as Santa made you, with the ability to come to life for 1 hour every night at 12 o'clock.
Oh, thank you, Fairy Snow Queen.
You're welcome, Santa. Oh, now what shall I find to do? Good night, Santa. It was fun. Oh, well. Oh, dear.
Come on, Snoopy. There's no time to lose. Let's put the toys in the sack. This is Christmas Eve.
Yes, sir, Santa. Yes, sir. And a good night to you, and a Merry Christmas, too.